Hello, my name is Mark Story. I teach symbolic logic here at Bellevue College, here in Bellevue, Washington, and welcome to this little series of videos. I've been teaching here for about 20, 25 years. Really enjoy it. I've been teaching symbolic logic for quite a while. If you're in my logic class, we've already met, and you probably already know something about me. What these videos are for is to present some of the visual elements of the class. There's going to be some things that if you missed seeing it in class because you're sick or you just had to miss class one day, it'd be really helpful to see it done. You can read the textbook and you should be doing that. You can be listening to somebody else, but you really need to see a couple things done. And so we're going to have about 10 videos, short, maybe 3 to 5 minutes each, looking at 9, 10 different specific visual elements. The first thing here is just basically an introduction, and I don't really need to show you anything, but I would like to really hammer home the one most important concept for this entire class is the notion of validity. If you're actually to spend 25 years, go on after this class, and remember only one thing about this class, I guess I'd be fairly content if you knew this one thing, this notion of validity. It's a concept. Arguments are going to go bad in one of two ways. We can speak really informally here. They've got to be logically good and factually good. That is, the premises of an argument need to give you good reason to believe the conclusion. And those premises need to be true. Here's some examples. I already got these written up on this fine little whiteboard, which I'm sure you're going to grow to love. Look at this first argument. All dogs are mammals. All mammals are animals. Thus, all dogs are animals. Just pretend the premises are true. Let's pretend all dogs are mammals. Easy to do because it's true. We know that's the case. And all mammals are animals. Again, it's easy to pretend that's true. If these two first things were true, that would absolutely guarantee that all dogs are animals. This would be what we call a valid argument. It's valid because the premises, the information in the premises, absolutely guarantee the conclusion. That's one of the things you want out of an argument. And this is a pretty good argument. Logically, it's good. The premises guarantee the conclusion, and the premises are true. It's logically good and factually good. Later on, we'll say it's valid and sound. But logically, we'd say it's valid. Look at the second argument, though. It's a little weird. All cats are fish. All fish are animals. Thus, all cats are animals. If you look at it closely, if the first two premises are true, there would be enough information in them to absolutely guarantee the conclusion. So logically, this is a good argument. It's, once again, valid. The premises are absolutely guaranteeing the conclusion. Now, it's a stupid argument, and we should get rid of it, but the reason we don't like it is that first premise is false. I mean, it's ridiculous to say all cats are fish. So it's factually bad, but it's logically good, so we call it valid. That's really the goal of this class, is to try to determine if certain arguments are going to be valid or invalid. That is, would the premises, if they were true, would they absolutely guarantee the conclusion? And we're going to get to the point where we don't even have to look at the English. It'll actually be much easier once we get into more of an abbreviated pattern. Check this argument here. You don't even know what I'm talking about because you don't know what P, Q, or S stands for. But I bet all of you could see it's a valid argument. If all P or Q, and it's also true that all Q or S, you see that it would be absolutely guaranteed that all P or S. And if you're saying, yes, I see that if these two were true, this would be guaranteed, you're doing logic, and you're doing exactly the kind of thing we need to do in this class. We're going to take techniques, we're going to learn techniques to be able to prove this is a valid argument. We're going to build on that kind of innate understanding you already have that if this is the case and this is the case, then this would have to be the case. We're going to build on that, learn techniques to prove things along those lines. But frankly, we're going to learn some techniques that are going to make you over most people's heads. You'll be having opportunities to prove arguments are good or bad that are going to be well beyond what some people will be able to understand. But you will be in a position to know that the argument's valid or invalid, probably instantaneously, because you'll be really good at this. And we're going to, as I say, we'll learn some techniques to be able to actually prove it. So these videos, they're going to be short. These videos are not designed to be the full class. You still need to be in class. You still need to be looking at the text. But if there's a visual element that you might be having a problem with, maybe the text isn't showing you how to set something up, I'm hoping that these videos can be of help to get you to succeed in the class. Anyway, good luck. Thanks.